In this lesson, we'll study how to format the headers or the column titles in Excel by freezing the very first row. We will also use the sum function to sum across a data range and the sum if function to selectively sum across a data range.
We have the Excel file open, store sales. So this file contains data on sales made by a store in Canada which sells office supplies online. So to start, let's increase the zoom level of this file from 100% to 150%. So at the bottom right-hand corner, we increase the zoom level to 150%. Next, notice that this file has headers. Every column has a header. So let's freeze that very first row. So what it'll do is it'll help us while we scroll down the file. So let's select the file, select the first row. Go to View, Freeze Panes, Freeze Top Row. So what it does now is it has frozen the top row. So as we scroll down, it's easy to see what that particular column consists of. We will now calculate the grand total sales made by the store across all these time periods, which simply is the sum of all the sales in column E. So let us go at the bottom of this file by pressing End and then down arrow. So it takes us to the very last row of the file. Notice we still see the headers. So we still know that column E is the sales column. So let us calculate the sum of this particular column. So let me put down the title here, Grand Total Sales. And that is nothing but the sum of column E. So the command to calculate the sum is equal to sum, open parenthesis, then I select this entire column E. So one easy way to select that is put your cursor in the very last cell of that column, do a Shift, Control, and up arrow. So it selects. Notice down here it has selected all the cells from E1 through E8400. Now notice the very first cell E1 is a header cell. We don't really need that. So let's change it to E2. And then we close parenthesis. So this is the grand total sales made by the store during this time period. It's about $14.91 million. Next, let us calculate total sales broken up as per customer segments. This store categorizes its customers into three segments or four segments: the home office segment, the corporate segment, consumer segment, and small business segment. So let's calculate sales across these four segments. So I put down total sales. Corporate segment. Total sales, the home office segment, total sales for the consumer segment, and total sales for the small business segment. Now, to calculate total sales specifically for the corporate segment, we use the sum if command. So we do a is equal to sum if, open parenthesis. Now this command requires three inputs. The very first input is the range which the if command refers to, which is nothing but column I. So let's select the entire column I. I put my cursor there, Shift, Control, up arrow. I really don't want it to start from I1, so I change it to I2. So that's my first input, the range which the if command refers to. Second input is the criteria. So within that range, I wish to sum up sales for the corporate segment. So I give a quotation mark, corporate, close quotation, then a comma. And the last input required is what particular column or what particular range needs to be selectively summed, which in our case is the sales column, which is column E. So I select the entire column E, shift, control, up arrow. Again, I don't need to start from E1, so I'll change it because E1 is my header. I'll change it to E2, and that completes my sum if command. Close parenthesis. And notice this is the sales during the entire period specific to the corporate segment. So this sales is about $5.49 million. We can also format these numbers by selecting them, doing a right click, format cells, choosing the currency format, and choosing an appropriate format to put the commas in, doing an OK, and maybe increase the size of spread of the column. So it's been formatted as per the dollar format. We can follow the same process to get total sales for the home office, consumer, and the small business segments. And you can confirm that the sum of sales for all the four segments taken together is indeed equal to the grand total sales.